wide betting race. Indominus bouncing around in the stools. They're off. Wakantanka got out very fast from the inside and through the first 100. He'll lead. Trade Him In was away quickly for Southam. Driving up now, looking for the front. Coming over Stock Taker, and Arno the Fox is going to sit just in behind those, followed by Bar Trader. Shake It was next of all. Out there three deep on the track, being followed in between horses. Next of all is Indominus, and down on its inside is One Point Lady. Getting back now as the field starts to bunch up is Dad's Big Headed. They've really slowed up the pace. Brother Paddy is back second from last, and he's over on the outside of Al Mahalo. Well, she's got them stacked and racked here at the 900 metre mark. Tradem now headed on the outside by Bar Trader and Stock Taker, who are trying to inject a little bit of pace, but Tradem kicks up underneath of both of them. Keeper Sweet is up prominent as well. She's really handy. A length away behind them came Arno the Fox in what's been a muddlingly run last. On the rails, Wakantanka. Shake It now. It goes around the outside. It takes off three and four deep to follow Bar Trader and Keeper Sweet. In turn, followed on the outside by Dad's Big Headed. Getting back behind them, Al Mahalo, One Point Lady. Also back there is Indominus and Brother Paddy. Now on the inside, Tradem regains the lead from Stock Taker, and Tradem draws a length down the outside is Keeper Sweet, though winding up. Wakantanka's just behind them. It's Tradem, Keeper Sweet down the outside. Further back is Shake It. Brother Paddy charging home. Tradem, Keeper Sweet. Look at Brother Paddy, Keeper Sweet, Tradem, Brother Paddy. Brother Paddy on the outside knocked them out. Brother Paddy down the middle of the course has won from a blanket finish for Minor Placings. Those spots filled either by Tradem In or Keeper Sweet, Arno the Fox. Right behind those then was Indominus. Dad's Big Headed finished solidly down the middle. Then Shake It, One Point Lady behind those. Wakantanka pulling up quickly in the run on. So did Stock Taker. Bar Trader is next. And Al Mahalo has finished back there at the tail of the field. Brother Paddy takes out the last for Lacto Romilly. Number seven, Brother Paddy, for trainer Kareen Maynard, has won from possibly Trade Him In, Keeper Sweet, Arno the Fox will be fourth. Here they are. Those numbers are 7-1-5-2. 7-1-5-2, the official placings after the running of the 1600 Ascend Sale Trophies handicap. Well, back there they were stacked and they were parked up behind Trade Him In. It was a bit of a cat and mouse tussle there. Tactically, Southam, though, wasn't going to concede the front completely, and she made the others work, regaining the lead. Challenged then by Keeper Sweet, who'd covered some ground, but it was Brother Paddy that was letting loose right down the centre of the track to knock them all out in the last of the day at a bit of odds. Three quarters and a short half head the margin, 7-1-5-2. They've run 137.57, 36.26, the last 600. Brother Paddy by Blackfriars, a seven-year-old out of Nurse Dormer, owned by David Reed, trained by Kareen Maynard, winning rider Lacto Romilly. Trade Him In second by Trade Fair from Movie World. Kate Southam aboard for trainer Todd Harvey, and Keeper Sweet third in by Gingerbread Man out of Keeper Quiet. Chet Stanley in the saddle for trainer Jeremy Easthope. And a fourth was to Arno the Fox. Let's go down now and join Britt for the last time in the winner's enclosure. And a few roughies in the legs of the quaddy this afternoon. This not essentially a long shot, but around that 11 into $9 mark and delivering with a big finishing run.
Hey, it's long enough, Mac. If you did manage to find Brother Paddy, I think you'd be on pretty good terms with yourself. Kareen Maynard now joins me. Yeah, you were thinking about taking this horse to Geraldton, decided, no, I think town would be a better option. I bet you're happy with that decision.
Yes, definitely a really good decision. I spoke to David, and I'd said to Lucky that we'll go to Geraldton, but then he's been running out of his class, and I thought it's best to put him back in his own class, and he did drop back in distance, but we freshened him up, and yeah, he proved us wrong.
200 metre mark, I don't even think I was looking at him. I was looking at all those ones out in front. At what point in the race did you think, hang on, we're a chance here?
I don't know. I know it takes him a long time to work up into the race, and Lucky's ridden him for all his wins now since I've had him. So I just left it in Lucky's hands, and yeah, I was a bit surprised though.
he monstered the line, didn't he? It was very fast finishing.
Well, I knew obviously because he'd been in 22s that he had the fitness in him, so it was just a matter of him grinding away and yeah.
Well, congratulations to you. Enjoy this win.
Thank you.
There is Karim Maynard with a brother Paddy who is victorious here in the last. As she mentioned, Lakdar knows him oh so well. There were no instructions for Lucky. It was, you know him, ride him just as you think. And for Lucky, that was back and just letting him attack the line. He flew home and, as she said, coming out of a 2200, he contested the Esperance Cup two starts ago and then gets back to a mile. He was always going to have fitness on his side and would be hitting the line strongly, and it was too strong for the rest of them.
Yeah, good training effort as well. Back 600 metres from that last start effort only a fortnight ago. And prior to that, Esperance Cup run, ran fifth of 16, beaten only four lengths by Off We Go, who heads to the Geraldton Cup this Sunday. Will no doubt be hard to beat. We'll get a quick word from Lakdar just before he speaks to the Happy Connections. But a great ride and a nice training performance by Corrine here as well. Lakdar, Corrine, just saying that you've ridden this horse to all of his wins. What were you thinking in running today with the muddling tempo?
Oh, I know this horse have descent. And I was back last, but I knew there was a 3D plan. When I have to move, I would just hop on. And yeah, good.
He sprinted really well in the straight when you're turning. Did you think you'd be able to get there in time?
Yeah, I hit a soft spot around the 600, around the corners, but then after this, pick up again, and I knew like he would hit the line hard.
Yeah, there he goes. Well for you. Well done.
Oh, thank you.
There is Lakdar Ramolli rounding out the day with a winner aboard a brother Paddy for Karim Maynard, which brings us to the end of our coverage here from Ascot this afternoon. Hopefully you've managed to find a winner or two amongst the seven race program. And now all eyes towards this weekend's meeting in the WA Derby. Can't wait for that.
Yeah, looking forward to that. Alaskan God v Tricks of the Trade does look a match race on paper. Alaskan God for me, though, I think he'll take all before him this campaign. And then we have the Geraldton Cup on Sunday.
Absolutely. Plenty of action out of the West over the weekend. Thanks for your company. Have a very good evening. I know it from the start. Maybe when you broke my heart, that I had to call my name and show you that.